In this Resolume Arena and Avenue 4 tutorial, we'll be discussing effect clips. How to use them dynamically and create effect stacks to recall different looks that can enhance your live visuals. I'll be going over a workflow where a mix of audio reactive effects and improvisational effects are created for live performance. Effect clips are a fast and easy way to create combined effects as presets to use on the fly. They can be triggered just like footage or visuals from any clip slot. They affect all the layers below it in the layer order. For this tutorial, I'll be placing all effect clips on the top layer of a four-layer composition. I have some already made here, but let's create one from scratch. First, I'll load up a visual from our Tunnel Vision set and another one from Dream Fields. If you haven't already, make sure you click on your Effects tab. And what we'll do now is choose an effect. I'll be using Goo, so drag the effect to an empty slot. And we'll rename this effect clip to Watercolor. Next, we'll change the values for max distortion on X, Y, and Z to about 0.05. Now I'll choose my next effect, and this one is Colorize. Go ahead and drag it on the same effect clip, and now the effects are stacked. We'll set the hue to cycle through all the colors using the timeline. I'll increase the speed a bit to about 1.5. So when we trigger this effect clip, we have an effect that'll shift colors automatically with liquid distortion. The advantage of using effects this way is we now have access to the blending modes, transitions, and opacity fader of the layer to control our effects. Here's how the effect looks with different blending modes. First, bring the opacity down to about 50%. So this is screen. This is hard light. And this is what the effect looks like with multiply. As you can see, the look of the effect changes as you change the blend mode. Let's bring the opacity back to 100%. When triggering a different effect clip on the same layer, it uses the selected transition mode. It's currently set at black and white, so when I trigger another effect clip, you can see that it uses that transition mode. I'm going to switch the mode to subtract. This is how the transition looks like when I use subtract. By using effect clips, you now have many transition modes available to blend between effects. For live situations, this can save you time and allow you to change the mood of the visuals instantly by triggering effect clips as needed. With the layer's fader, we can fade our effects in and out easily. I have one of my MIDI controller's faders linked to the effect clip layer's opacity fader. Now you can improvise by blending effects to the beat or go crazy as you see fit. Let's go ahead and load up some new visuals here. Now let's talk about the two settings in effect clips. The first is input. What input does is combines the footage of a chosen layer with the effects inside of an effect clip. I'll choose layer 3 as the input layer for our watercolor effect clip. The effects in the effect clip are applied and mixed with layer 3 and displayed as a single visual when triggered. At first, you might get confused and not know what happened. Since the effect clip is using a layer as input, the layer you choose as input does not require any opacity, but it still needs to be triggered. I'll lower the opacity of layer 3 to 0, and the opacity of the watercolor effect clip to 50% so it blends with the layers below it. So now anytime you trigger a visual on layer 3, it'll receive all the effects from our watercolor effect clip. I'll trigger a few visuals so you can see it in action. Notice that the background colors don't change at all. This is a nice way to isolate effect clips on single layers. let's change the input of our effect clip back to composition. Let's also change our layer 3 opacity back to 50%, and the effect clip layer's opacity back to 100%. We'll also switch the visual here. So the other setting on an effect clip is duration. When using autopilot on your effect clips, the duration controls how long an effect clip plays. From the Layer tab, let's activate Autopilot Playback to see this in action. The 5000 value is equal to 5 seconds, but this is where you can set it to whatever you please. As you can see, it's automatically switching the effect clip after every 5 seconds. Now let's get into some tips and techniques for effect clips. The first is merging effect clips for new looks. Let's say there's a combination of effect clips you want to try. Hold Alt or Option and drag your effect clips to make a duplicate copy on any empty slot. For this example, I'll be using Glow Blast and Rolling Stripes. In each of these effect clips, we have various effects listed, which you'll notice right here. By holding Shift and dragging one of the effect clips on another, you'll notice that the effects are now combined. Now you have a single effect clip that you can trigger all these effects on. This is great for testing out new looks. Another simple tip is that you can add effects on the layer of your effect clips. So if you have some favorite effects that you like to use on all of your effect clips, you can just store them on the layer instead of storing them individually inside of the effect clip. As you can see, I have a few effects loaded here on the layer itself. And this is just another way to have more flexibility if you need it. The next tip involves repositioning the effect clip's layer. So rather than isolating the layer that you want the effect clip on by using the input, you can just reposition the entire layer. By pressing the up or down button, you can reposition the whole layer and just isolate the layers underneath. The visual above my effect clips layer is now unaffected by the effect clips. Keep in mind that some shortcuts may be affected if you swap the layer order, so just beware. Speaking of shortcuts, a fun way to improvise is by triggering your effect clips on the fly. By setting shortcuts, you can instantly trigger effect clips for a more dynamic performance. The various effect clips that we have here are easily triggered by using keyboard shortcuts that we've set to the number keys. The first 5 effect clips that we have are auto-reactive to the bass frequencies, and we've labeled them with AR next to their names. I'll play some music so you can see and hear them in action. This first effect clip is called Bump, and this is essentially a visual bass thump. The next is Spastic, and what this does is cycles through colors and triggers a ghosting effect on the beat. Pixely adds pixelated lo-fi artifacts, and Line Show flashes glowing lines and outlines over the visuals. Beat Strobe tweaks the visibility and flashes visuals to the audio. The rest of the effects don't react to audio, but are dynamic enough to stand on their own. I use these to improvise using the opacity fader of the layer. TV Trash simulates bad TV reception. Old Timer recreates an old school monochromatic movie look. Hypnotical is a trippy hypnotic effect used for slowing down the mood. Rolling Stripes slices and rotates your visuals. And Glow Blast allows you to add a glow to your visuals, perfect for fading in and out to music. We've made these effect clips available as a Resolume composition file, which you can download for free to see how these effects were created. Feel free to customize and create your own versions. The download link is in the description of this tutorial. We hope this tutorial helped you understand effect clips better and provided some creative ways to use these in your live visuals. Effect clips are a powerful feature of Resolume and can allow for some versatility when it comes to applying various effects over the course of a live set. All the visuals used in this tutorial are available at docoptic.com, along with additional tutorials to get you up to speed with Resolume. Thanks for watching and for all your support. Have fun playing with Resolume and see you next time.